All right, welcome back. Let's start this show. Last time, we were being chased after the gate closed, so now we gotta run. All right, welcome back. We gotta run for our life, because they're on our back. Best quest says run. Get a horse. To the world, they said. We must run to safety. I'm a brave boy. I'm gonna save her. Horse riding. I did my job. She's out. X. Hammer. Time to run. I'm a brave boy. I'm a brave boy. Hey, he's the exact same horse. My leg. At least it's not that joke, so I'm happy with that. Time to run. Oh dear, they're right on my back. They still shoot at me. Oh!
Left. Hamburg is to the left along the stream.
I wonder what happens if you go right. What will happen?
Flee!
I think I lost one of them.
Warn the others.
Nope, they stopped three. Scallops. Run, sir. Don't get trampled. The sad part when I start slowing down, that's when they will catch up easily. This gap is good right now. Oh, they cut. That's why.
Run for it.
That fast.
Don't. Let's see. They'll kill you all.
Whew. Now they're up on me. Don't shoot me.
Warn the others. They tore at Scarlet.
Whoa. I should be safe now, hopefully. Don't shoot me. That's all I asked for. Come on, get to it. I know, horse. I know. Oh, I know, horse. It's rough on you. I'm not even on my Xbox, I still get invites to my Xbox. I'm just trying to do a simple let's play and that's gonna happen, no matter what.
Help! Quickly everyone! Get your asses out!
Hey! And... loose! Hang your horses in there!
While this cutscene's going on, let me tell them real quick, I'm doing. tell him I'm doing quickly recording.
Quickly! We're closing the gate!
Someone give him a drink. And bring hot wine and bandages. Tell me, boy, who are you and where are you from? What in hell's name happened?
I've come from Scalitz. They burned it to the ground. Slaughtered everyone.
Who? Who burned it to the ground?
A huge army. They attacked without warning. And they weren't Czechs or Germans either.
Who then?
I don't know. I've never seen armor like it or heard their language. Maybe Tatars?
My lord.
Tatars, you say? Well, we'll deal with that later. First, let's have a look at that leg of yours. Grit your teeth, boy. I'm gonna pull that arrow out.
So, side note, while this is still going through, and I'm going through the pain and agony through my leg, my friend that's going to be doing recording / streaming with me also, he just got his computer ordered, so
you were lucky, lad.
Him and I are going to be doing a lot more games together, too.
It only needed bandaging, and I've done that often enough before. War is a good teacher. Can you stand? There you go. Good as new.
Thank you. Dick. It's going to be like that. I'm already in pain.
You
right
idlers, nothing better to do. Get back to work. You'll have to speak to Lord Divish. Can you manage? Sir, this is a survivor from...
I heard, Robart. Tell me, boy, what exactly happened? Did you see the ensigns of the attackers? Were there any more survivors?
Sir, I don't know what army it was, but it was huge. There were dozens of banners flying on the hill above Scalitz. The ones who did the slaughtering spoke a strange language. They burned Scalitz to the ground. But a lot of people took refuge in the castle. I wasn't quick enough. And as I fled, they shouted from the battlements that I should come and warn you.
The soldiers the boy didn't recognize. They could be those Cumans of Sigismund's. It said they came to Hungary from the east, and now they're the core of his army. Sacking Gutenberg must have given him a taste for stolen silver.
Uh-oh.
Scalitz is a small castle, sir. If Sigismund attacks, they can't hold.
Indeed, sir.
Sounds like a war is brewing.
And our small garrison would be no help, even if we could risk sending them.
You think we're next in line?
Maybe. What's your name, boy?
I'm Henry.
Or Hal.
Son of the Scalitz blacksmith.
I know him. Did he make it inside the castle?
Sorry. Sadly not.
It's in God's hands now. No one else can help us. Anyway, thank you for risking your neck to warn us. Robard, take care of Henry. Make sure he gets something to eat and some rest.
Yes, sir.
And get all the people inside the gates. We have to prepare for the worst. Make all the necessary arrangements.
As you command, sir.
I didn't forget you still hit me the back and everything that hurt. I was injured here. Okay.
You've done well, lad. I'm sorry for your loss. You must be all done in. Why don't you go to the kitchen and have a good meal? Sorrow is easier to bear on a full stomach. I heard about your father. They say he was a swordsmith who moved to the countryside to make fortune. I can't understand why he'd waste his talents, but I'm sure he had his reasons.
So shiny.
He had a fine reputation.
Ah, milady. You're fortunate our good lady Stephanie of Talmberg has graced us with her presence.
Milady, I'm honored.
Milady.
So this is our brave young man. Welcome, lad. Bojena here will take care of you. No doubt you're Bojena. Tired and hungry.
Indeed. How could he not be, poor soul? After everything he's been through, he must be as hungry as a bear, aren't you, young master? Here you are, then.
Hungry as a
Eat
bear.
Eat Phil. Huh. And a little wine to wash it down.
Thank you, my lady.
My lady.
When you're done, you can go and rest with the grooms in the outer bailey.
No, that won't do, Sir Robard. After all he's been through, he deserves a proper bed. Let him sleep in a lodge in the courtyard.
Certainly, my lady.
Thank you, my lady.
Young Henry here is overwhelmed by your generosity.
Yes, yes.
And your
Thank
beauty.
You, my lady. May God reward you for your kindness.
Eat up now. You're in capable hands, so I'll leave you to it. Good night.
Me lady.
Good night, ma'am.
When you've done, you can sleep in the bedchamber of the courtyard lodge. And don't forget to take off those filthy boots before getting into bed.
Okay. I'll make sure to take off my boots then. My boots that dirty or something? They don't seem like they're that dirty. Good thing I brought this food with me. Survive, but roasted duck I would take. Take this wine. I want some more fruit. Take two apples. Alright, you're good. Stand there, I keep thinking like I can actually say something to you. Oh, wait. I'm actually going to do it too. I know you don't have to, but took off my boots, he said. People, I am not on Xbox Live right now. Alright, my boots are taken off. I haven't slept in 2 hours? That's it? No, that can't be it. I think he's just saying that's how long before a cutscene happens. I took my shoes off. Is he happy?
Yes?
It is I, Henry. the intrusion. I didn't wake you, boy, did I?
My lady,
Sit.
No, not at all.
Me lady.
But what brings you here at this hour?
I thought you could do with a little wine.
Sure, my lady.
It's just what you need to help you sleep.
My lady, thank you. You really shouldn't. You could have sent a sermon.
I was going to, but to tell you the truth, I couldn't sleep either. I thought of you while saying my prayers. How awful it must have been for you. I came to offer you solace, to let you know you're not alone.
Thank you,
my lady. That's gonna be my word, my lady.
You're welcome. Now, Henry, I know this is all very new and strange for you.
My lady's touchy.
But I want you to feel at home here. You're not to worry about anything except getting better. God knows you've been through a terrible ordeal. I know what it is to be left alone in the world. Although your loss is much greater. But with God's help, the pain will ease in time.
In time.
And it can help to talk about it. If you feel like it.
I'm playing charismatic, so I'm always willing to talk.
Might be right, m'lady.
M'lady?
I'll tell you what happened. It was terrible and unexpected. The day started just like any other. Father sent me into town on some errands. A fellow by the name of Kunesh owed money to Father, who sent me to collect it from him. Only Kunesh had no intention of paying. It got a bit heated, as often happens when there's money involved. But Kunesh still wouldn't cough up the coin. Father was too generous for his own good, letting even a scoundrel like that buy on credit.
Oh.
When I'd done all the errands, I headed back home. I promised Father I'd help him with his work, and I was looking forward to it. He was forging a sword for Sir Radzin. Father and I always chat in the forge. On that particular day, I asked him if he'd teach me swordsmanship. He said no. He said it's better for a man to keep his head on his shoulders than lose it over some pointless heroism. If only you'd known what fate had in store for us.
Right. Oh.
But Sigismund's horde was already on the horizon, ready to attack the town. A horde of soldiers was amassed. Pennants flapped in the wind, the armor glinted in the sunlight, and the horses whinnied impatiently. They were waiting for Sigismund to give the command to attack.
How awful.
And then death descended on Skalitz. The gate to the castle was open. The bells and horns sounded the alarm, and the villagers ran to the castle to take cover. They were carrying the few possessions they could grab in haste, and I saw the terror in their eyes.
I can't even imagine how awful it must have been.
I ran to the castle like our neighbors to take cover, but I didn't make it. I had to find another way to save myself. The men on the battlements called down to me to flee to Talmberg and warn you. I was lucky I knew a concealed path around the castle. I no longer heard any sounds of battle coming from the castle, so Sigismund's army must have regrouped and started preparing for siege.
No doubt you're right.
Then I heard a scream.
I wonder if that all changes.
It was Teresa, the mill wench. She'd been caught by a gang of Cuman savages who planned to violate her. I had Sir Radzik's sword, and even though there were several of them and they were better armed, I had to try and save her. I wanted there to be at least one person I'd helped. and I succeeded, even though it almost cost me my life. After that, I stole a horse from them and rode off.
Like a valiant knight.
If you don't do it, you can lie about it.
It will haunt me for the rest of my life.
It's terrible. How could something like that happen?
God alone knows why he lets such things happen.
You poor boy. I understand your grief, but God is not to blame for the ills of this world. That is the work of Satan and those who do his bidding. Those who are corrupted by greed, envy, and pride. You must not lose faith, whatever life brings. Fate has not been merciful to me, and my husband either. Although in comparison to the horrors he went through. I was young when I married my husband. It was my father's wish. Divish was a lot older than I, but a woman must bear her lot. Shortly after our marriage, before I even got a look at Talmberg, the castle was stormed and my husband was imprisoned.
Really?
My husband had some quarrel with Sir Havel Medek of Valdek, who decided to resolve it by force. He stormed the castle, burned down the village of Pribislavitz, and killed many of our men, even the old chamberlain. He imprisoned my husband in the castle and put his own garrison there.
That's awful.
I was barely 18 years old, and all of a sudden, I was left alone with Sir Robert. We didn't know what to do. We went to Prague to appeal to the king and sought help from Divish's friends, but all to no avail. We tried for years, but it seemed I was destined to be left alone and my husband to rot in jail in his own castle.
Years, you say?
7 years. That's how long it took before Havel was condemned as an enemy of the crown. And even then, he refused to surrender the castle and release my husband. In the end, I raised the money to pay a ransom, and only then, by the grace of Lord Jesus, did I finally lay eyes on my husband once more.
7 years. And was Havel punished for it?
Never.
Never.
And after 7 years, my husband returned to me an infirm old man.
Sir Divish seems like a good, strong man.
Certainly, only he has many concerns. He had to rebuild Talmberg. After he was released, the king appointed him Burgrave of Prague Castle, and he was very busy. He had no time for me at all. But at least we were in the city, and there was something going on. Now, we're here.
My lady, you're still young. Beautiful. Your best years are still ahead of you.
Would that that were true, lad. Would it were true. But what am I doing bothering you with this? You have troubles enough of your own. I'll go.
It's still good to hear other troubles. It helps comfort people when they know other people are in trouble too.
I enjoyed our little talk, Henry. Good night, and God bless.
Good night.
We all are sharing the same type of emotion, either good emotions or bad emotions, sad or happy. If we share the emotions together, we're happy together.
Come on, we've got a time! Quickly!
but you told me not to fight, Father. Ah, guilt gets to me.
Henry, wake up. You don't want to miss this.
What is it? What's happening?
Come to the battlements. One of our patrols reported a company heading here from Scallops.
Hey, I took off my shoes like you asked. They don't look dirty. Wait, I want that torch. So I can see.
What's going on?
I don't know. It doesn't make sense. Why would Sigismund advance on Talmud in the night? Especially since he's lost the element of surprise after the raid on Scallops.
Maybe it's not him.
Then who is it? The scouts Divish sent to Scallops to spy on Sigismund said he'd set up camp and was getting ready to storm the castle. And Sir Radzig is an experienced soldier. He'd surely hold the castle for quite some time. It doesn't make sense.
What else did this body see?
Not much of anything. Before they could get close enough, this huge storm started. And you were right. Sigismund has a hell of a lot of soldiers, including all manner of mercenaries. An army like that costs a fortune. Well, anyway, we'll find out when they get here, won't we?
Aye, we will.
Oi.
What a relief.
Is his lordship there with you?
Yes, sir. He is right here.
What are you doing up so late, Divish? At your age, you need a good night's sleep.
I like that name, Divish.
Exactly picked the best time for an outing either. In a big hurry?
It was a bit of a scramble, all right. Believe it or not, this tempest is a godsend for me and my men. As my old granddad used to say, better a sore throat than a slit throat.
I'd say your grandfather was a wise man. Your messenger told us what happened.
Messenger?
The lad you sent to warn us.
He's alive? He made it to you?
He's here with me. He only got away by the skin of his teeth, though.
Thank God.
A brave young man. But tell me, friend, how on earth did you manage to get away?
Thank God for this tempest. When it began, Sigismund's Tatars crawled into their holes and left the storm in the castle for more clement weather. We were able to sneak out right under their noses. The Lord be praised. We wouldn't have stood a chance against them.
Would you like to spend the night in Tumber?
No, no. When Sigismund finds the castle empty tomorrow, he might come looking for us. We'd only be exposing you to danger. Without me and my men, he has no call to attack you.
What will you do then?
We'll march to Ratai. It's only a short way, and there we'll have a better chance of defense, and enough room for all of these people. If Sigismund should come, better bend your knee, Divish. There's no point dying in a battle that's futile.
You're right there.
Oh, yeah.
Is that boy still with you?
I'm here, sir.
You have courage, lad. That I can't deny. I am sorry about what happened. Would you care to join us?
I'd like to, sir, but first I have to return to Skellix.
Are you mad? What do you want there?
I can't leave my mother and father. I won't leave their corpses rotting in the street. I'll join you once I've taken care of.
Don't even think of going back there, you donkey. Are you tired of living?
Sir!
Quiet! I'm sorry about your father. But getting killed as well won't help him. Divish, make sure that lad doesn't budge from Talberg until things quiet down.
Not to worry, friend. Anyway, he's injured and needs to recover. I'll lock him up here as if he were Hobble of Baltic.
I don't get it.
You've grown a thick skin since your tribulation, sir. But thank you. We'll meet again when circumstances are more favorable. Farewell.
Farewell,
and good fortune. Give my regards to Sir Hanish.
I will. And good luck to you and your people, too. These are dark times. Move out!
Dark time. Lightning strikes. It's a dark time. Foreboding. That entire conversation, there was no lightning storm, no thunder. Well, it probably been lightning, but just no thunder. But as he got done, saying foreboding thunderstorm.
Man, tonight we'll have triple patrol. Sort out the watches between you as always. And if I catch anyone boozing, playing dice, or slacking off, I'll personally break every bone in his body. I want you to keep a close eye on everything nearby. Sigismund will surely have sent spies, and likely men as well, to follow the Scalas people. Now he knows they've fled. Keep your eyes peeled. Report everything to me at once. Understood?
Sir.
What is it you need?
I could use an extra pair of eyes. Yours are key. Will you keep watch on the battlements with my men?
Is that a request or an order?
I'd rather it was a request you answered yes to.
Of course I'll help. I'll have to pay you back somehow after all you've done for me.
Splendid. Uh-huh. Don't worry. I'll tell the men to relieve you later.
Do-do-do-do-do-do, just waiting out the time, da-da-da-da-da-da, going around the town. I know I should be here, but it doesn't matter. Do-do-do! So dark. You see those two lights out there? The darkness consumes everything right there. To see something right there, but I have no idea what that is. Oh, I see a thing. No, there's something right there. Where I'm pointing at, right there on the dot. It's like something right there. Oh, there's another view right there too. But hell, I'm blind, so I can't see that well.
Wandering around like a stray sheep. Must be your first watch, eh? I don't think anything much will be happening today. You can just lean against the wall and wait till morning. I'll show you.
I will. Thank you.
Get up against the wall? Okay. Thank you. Oops, no, I hit the wrong button always. Wait until morning, okay. This music right now sounds very fantasy-like. Like you're gonna see a whole bunch of woodland creatures and stuff like that.
What health do you?
What do you think about how the Skellig's folk managed to flee the siege?
Thank the Lord. I thought it was Sigismund descending on us.
Seems everyone thought that.
Well, we were all expecting the worst. And the truth is, I'm still worried what will happen when Sigismund comes here. And come he will, of that I'm sure. I just hope we'll be as fortunate when we're face to face with that fucker. By the way, Henry, my condolences.
Thank you.
Everybody in this town's gonna know my name too. Skellig's where I'm from. Everybody knew me. That's a lot of people.
See how the self-appointed king wins the love and respect of his loyal subjects.
Indeed, Robard. Sigismund of Luxembourg has a rare talent for winning people over to his cause. You may be in for a surprise. I don't think he will set his heathen dogs on us today.
Greetings, Lord of Tomberg.
That's the bastard who led the attack of Skellig and killed my parents.
Don't be an idiot. Do you want to end up like them?
No, but I want my revenge on them.
I am Sir Markvart von Aulitz. I come in the name of Sigismund of Luxembourg, King of Hungary and Croatia, who has resolved to strike against those who disrupt concord in the land, and to restore order in the name of his brother, King Wenceslaus IV.
Restore order by burning and pillaging the king's estates.
Greetings, Sir Markvart. The efforts of the king's brother to bring order to this chaotic land are undoubtedly noble. It seems to me, though, that he and his army have somewhat strayed.
I know that bald guy sees me.
As Burgrave of Prague Castle,
unless
I am
he doesn't
entirely
recognize
beholden
me or thought about me.
And here in Talmberg, divine peace reigned until your arrival.
I want him dead.
What then do we owe the honor of your visit?
Yesterday, His Majesty took action against the enemy of the kingdom, the Ratzik Kobila, who has been using the silver from the Skellig's mine to fund insurrection against the crown.
Unfortunately, oh, really now?
The insurgent escaped. Would you happen to know, noble sir, where he might be at this time?
As far as I know, the Sir Radzik of which you speak is the king's hetman at Skellig's. I find it hard to imagine that he would rebel against our king. Nevertheless, I can assure you that Sir Radzik is not at Talmberg. He would be a fool indeed to flee from one castle, where he has little chance of defense, to another, where he has even less. Or do you take the view that my humble manner is any obstacle to your army?
Am I to inform the king then that Ratzik Kobila is not a Tomberg and that he has your loyalty?
Sir Radzik Kobila is not here, and I have no intentions of getting embroiled in affairs from which I have nothing to gain.
Very well, sir.
He worded it perfectly.
As you wish.
Yeah, get mad.
Relay your words to the king in the hope he will be as well disposed as you seem to be.
Those who have clean consciences and goodwill may find themselves well disposed even at moments like this, when there's little cause for joy. Farewell, sir.
Auf Wiedersehen.
I always said that was a V instead of a W. Unless I read that wrong. He has a strong tongue. I want to be a king like him, with a tongue like that. Because he told him he is the one, the part of the alliance of you. If he doesn't gain nothing, he knows what Sir Ramsay already told him. So he already knew about the whole army attack.
My lord, you have my utmost admiration.
Get on with you, Robard.
I will have my revenge on you. And anybody has to die, it's only him. Nobody else has to die to me. Everybody else can live, all I care about. But it's only one bloodshed that has to be drawn. Nice pillar walk. It's only one bloodshed that has to be spilled. And that's the murderer. Here we go.
God be with you.
Where did these humans come from, anyway?
I don't know much about them, only what the Chamberlain said. That they came to Hungary from the east and settled there. They're godless barbarians and merciless fighters. The nobles used to say the Hungarian king shouldn't enlist them, because they dishonor our rules of warfare. But when there's power and money to be had, it seems that honor isn't worth my spit. And believe me, it's always about power and money.
Oh, yes.
What happened in Gutenberg?
Gutenberg? Well, I'm just a simple soldier. But the good Lord gave me ears, and I've heard some things from Sir Divish and from those who fled from Sigismund's village.
Were there many?
Indeed. But it was the Gutenberg mercenaries who came to see me, because I knew them from before.
I see.
Listen, lad, these are all games of the high aristocracy. In Prague, a cabal of nobles rebelled against King Wenceslas, wealthy aristocrats who took against our king for reasons of their own. There's no doubt Sigismund had his fingers in the whole affair. Him and Wenceslas's cousin, Jobst. And that cabal helped him abduct the king.
So then why did Sigismund attack Gutenberg?
Why do you think?
I suppose... because it has a strategic position and good fortifications, so it can be used as a base for raids, giving you control of the whole territory and good defenses too, if you need them.
Not at all. King Charles, may God grant him eternal glory, built Prague into a proper royal city, while King Wenceslas took a liking to Gutenberg. After Prague, it's the most important city in Bohemia. In the entire Holy Roman Empire.
Bohemian Rhapsody?
He who commands the Gutenberg silver is king.
So Gutenberg sided with Wenceslas because he favored it.
Now you're starting to understand. When Sigismund imprisoned Wenceslas and took control of Prague, the people of Gutenberg began to raise an army against him. So with the attack on Gutenberg, Sigismund killed two birds with one stone. He defeated Wenceslas's most powerful allies before they could stand against him
and also gained immense wealth.
Why did Sigismund burn down Scalitz and then come here too?
That's war for you, lad. Certain lords have resolved to take things into their own hands and eliminate anyone who doesn't share their view. Unfortunately, Sir Ratzig is one of those. And what's more, he was sitting on a pile of silver that could help King Wenceslas's allies.
So, Robart, I need to get to Scalitz.
What would you do there, lad? Sigismund might have left, but the place will be swamped with robber barons, brigands, deserters, and other vermin. And anyway, your lord commanded you to stay here.
My parents died there, and I won't leave them to be ravaged by dogs. I have to bury them.
Good God, boy. Do you want to throw your life away for those who can never get theirs back? Do you think that's what they'd want? Forget it.
I had to try.
Is it possible? And that's not all. They say.
Okay, so we're almost at the end of what I played already. Let's get out of this little city, and then once we do, we'll be almost set to play it. For what I don't know about, it'll be all a new game to me. M'lady, m'lady. You're not m'lady.
Huh? What are you doing?
Sorry, I'm just trying to get through, yo. You're not m'lady. Where's m'lady? M'lady. Ha-woo. So I don't think it works like that. I don't think I'm supposed to notice you either. No matter what, every time I walk this way, I want to turn right. It's like, clunk. I can't go that way. Where's my lady at?
I wouldn't say that. Oh, you want to stick your head out the door now and again, you old lady? First in harvest to now with armies invading and pillaging, I...
I need my lady to give me some coin. Wrong still books, but I want to read. Oopsie, I ran into him.
Hey!
Hello. Why do you look up my... Oh, you got bees on your neck. I was like, what is that?
God
knows what it was.
You said something about the name. What was it about?
Nothing terribly urgent. Just a reminder from your cousin that he'll come in mind.
Ah, I see. Well, remind me the week before he arrives, so I'll have time to prepare properly for his visit.
Of course.
They don't have any lockpicks. I know I didn't have any lockpicks, but I had to still see. So, what does he do? Read. Yeah, I can't read that. But nothing to your stats or anything. Where's me lady? I need me lady to help me get up. Wait, oh, I know where she's at. My lady, I'm coming to you. My lady. Ah.
The Lord save you. What do you need?
My lady. I hope you weren't unduly distressed by the arrival of Sigismund's army.
I'll do that first before asking for everything else.
It was to be expected. And thanks to God's mercy and my good husband, there was no more bloodshed. But it's something else that distresses me. Maybe my mind deceives me. But I have an evil foreboding.
You, my lady? Surely not. No evil could possibly come to you.
I fear something bigger and worse will come. That Sigismund is only another omen of imminent evil. Of great evil.
I would like to ask your assistance, my lady, if I may be so bold.
What's the matter, lad?
I need to get out of the castle. Your husband is keeping me here by force.
Why, for the love of God, would you want to leave the castle?
My parents are lying in the mud of Skellets at the mercy of dogs and jackdaws. I can't just leave them there.
That's terrible. May the Lord have mercy on their souls. But how can I help you, Henry? I don't want your death on my conscience.
If I could just get past the guard at the gate somehow.
But you can. If you wear a proper suit of armor, and if he can't see your face, he won't recognize you and he'll let you go.
Good thinking.
I never said the face parts. I never found any armor.
Where
can
I get the armor?
At the armory?
Where's that?
In the gate tower. But the soldiers sleep in other places around the castle too, and you might find armor nearby.
It's rather embarrassing, but if I'm to pay a bribe, I need money. Fortunately, I don't have any.
How would you? Don't worry your head about it. This should be enough.
Thank you, my lady. I will repay
you. Bribe is enough for him. It's just like I have money.
They'll certainly ask where I'm going.
You could tell them Sir Robard sent you to Ujit's. To ask the parish priest how the folk there are faring.
That sounds reasonable. Thank you.
Oh, hello.
I must go now.
Alright, so let's see if I can make this work. If I can find some armor in the armory. Hence, I don't know where it's at still. But, I've gotten better at lockpicking trying to do this so much. Talk to the trader. I feel bad that I'm being a thief, but...
Good day to you. What do you need?
I had to meet so I can get out of this... forsaken...
Can we trade?
...city. I'm being held hostage. Here on my table. I want to buy a lockpick. Just one. That's 18 gold. I'd sell you... a bad arrow. Okay, that's what it's for. I said you that. And that.
No, no. That looks like stolen goods. I won't buy that.
God damn it. How'd you know that was stolen? Wait a minute, but I took the other stuff before. Oh, I know what I did.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
Alright, I know what I did. So let me just buy just the lockpick. One lockpick. Let's see if I can lower the price a little bit.
Let's have a word about the price.
Naturally.
$15.50.
Satisfied?
Come now. Just a little more and we have a deal.
Just one gold difference.
I knew we'd come to an arrangement.
I guess that will work. I can sell those, even though I'm stealing it. Okay, it's a lot easier for me to lockpick stuff now. I almost failed that though. And I steal that, but he'll take that stuff. Makes no sense. Hello, distance guy. Ooh. Ain't no fall damage on that one. That wasn't too high for it. There is fall damage, and I fell plenty of times to hurt myself. I try to steal everything. I just want to get some stuff started. All right. So watch. Well, let me actually. Stuff that I need. See if I wear this helmet, it doesn't cover my face, so they still see me no matter what. So I never understood this purpose of the armor right there. But I digress, watch. He'll buy the shields and everything.
Can we trade?
If you've got the coin.
Let's have a word about the price.
See, he'll buy that. He doesn't realize that as stolen stuff. Can I get 9 for it?
Are we agreed?
That sounds pretty interesting. A little less and I'll be satisfied.
A little less. That's not a little less.
Well, that's a decent price.
Now, a weird thing, I can actually try to jump this with a horse in the past. I got the horse stuck. It was stuck in midair forever. So I learned my lesson on that.
Hey! Look where you...
You ran into me. I need to eat because there's no food right there. So, let's eat this. Nourishment 54. So I need more still. Too much. Think they see me every time.
What was that?
Do, do, do.
Do you need help?
That was close.
Jesus Christ be praised.
Over here.
Wrong button. How many more lockpicks do I have? 3. Okay. Let's make it to the my home. Oh, hello. There's no way I'll be able to get out the city, so use my old tactics. Stuck. Some way I know I can. My horse changed on me.
You'll have to wait for me here, friend. Better to keep going on my own.
So many dead. Such a disgusting sight. You had to have a strong stomach for that if you really was in that moment. Homecoming. Alright, on that note, I'll catch you next episode. See you next time.